So let's move to the conclusion. So with our Xcube AWS 2.0 solution, we enable secure communication with TLS by making use of STSAFE A110 to protect our TLS assets, hence securing the data we exchange with the cloud. This is the first very important thing. We also ensure device and firmware integrity. Thanks to our secure boot, we can trust the application we run. We have seen that with the SBCFU certificate chain, we are able to verify the signature of this application. And thanks to the secure firmware update, we can maintain the security level during the product lifecycle. We can upgrade the firmware in a secure manner. And we ensure data integrity thanks to the STM32 security IPs and thanks to secure runtime services provided by KMS. So we can conclude that our objectives are met. With the STSAFE A110 secure element, we combine the AWS multi-account registration together with the SPL02 profile to bring an easy possibility to connect to AWS. We have a tamper-resistant storage to protect our assets, the device certificate, the device private key, as well as the SBSFU certificate. But again, don't mix up. On one side, we have the device certificate and device private key used to connect to Amazon. And on the other side, we have the SBSFU certificate used for authenticating the application before running it. All these elements are stored in STSAFE, but they are not for the same purpose. Our TLS assets are not exposed out of the secure element. This is an important point. The device private key remains in the STSAFE. It's never exposed. And with Xcube SBSFU, we authenticate the user application thanks to the secure boot feature. We have the secure firmware update allowing us to implement secure OTA. And thanks to all these elements, we build a fortified solution with a secure MCU framework and we provide secure runtime services exposed thanks to the key management services layer, KMS, and it's zoned for a standard API, PKCS 11. It's also selected by Amazon and well known in the industry.